हेलो, वेलकम टू ऑल इन माय बायोलॉजी क्लास। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी क्लास एट टॉपिक एंड द चैप्टर वन। द टॉपिक्स नेम, द चैप्टर्स नेम इज द लिविंग वर्ल्ड एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ माइक्रोब्स। इन दैट लिविंग वर्ल्ड वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन द लास्ट प्रीवियस ईयर्स रिलेटेड टू द लिविंग वर्ल्ड, रिलेटेड टू द एडाप्टेशन, रिलेटेड टू द अर्थ लिविंग सिस्टम। In that living world, we have already seen related to the microbes, related to the plants, related to the animals. So these all things are comes under the living world. So as we have seen in the last previous year, we have already seen different type of living systems and living things are there in our earth. So in relation to the 2011 census, we have seen 87 million total species are there in all over the world on the earth. So related to the 87 million, as we have calculated, 1 million equals to 10 lakh. So you have to calculate that 87 million, that means 0000. Okay, so as we have seen in the all the classification of the microbes, a very first classification comes into the history, and that comes into the history in 1735, which is given by Carl Linnaeus. With that, he invented a two kingdom classification system. So in that classification, he divide all the living system into only two systems, that is Vegetabilia and Animalia. But he forget about, or that system is having some limitations, and because of that limitations, we some elements drop down that idea for the classification, and the new discovery is again invented, and that is invented in 1866 by Haeckel, scientist Haeckel. He divides a three kingdom classification system. According to the three kingdom classification system, he invented protista, plants and animals in that three kingdom classification system. But what about fungi? What about microbes? He did not tell about all the living system in all over the world. So after the theory of scientist Haeckel, the new scientist came into the picture, and that scientist name is Chaton in 1925, and he invented two kingdom classification system. According to two kingdom classification system, he invented that classification into two types, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. He invented only prokaryotes and eukaryotes, and he divides all the living system into two groups only. So this theory is having some limitations. After some times, a new scientist is came into the picture, and that name of that scientist is the Copeland in the 1938. With that, he invented four kingdom classification system. With that four kingdom classification system, he divides all the living system into four classes. What are they? That four classes are Monera, Protista, Planti and Animalia. Planti, Animalia, Protista and Monera. But he did not include the fungi into the four kingdom classification system, and because of these limitations, what will happen? The another system or the another theory of classification came into existence, and that system is invented in 1969, the year 1969. This theory is very essential and important. As of now, we all are followed that kingdom, five kingdom classification system invented by R.H. Whittaker, Robert Whittaker, and he discovered five kingdom classification system. With that five kingdom classification system, he includes all the living system into the five kingdom classification system. So, five kingdom into Monera, first one, second one is the Protista, third one is the Fungi, fourth one is the Plantae, and fifth one is the Animalia. He included each and every individual ecosystem in the universe to the five kingdom system. So that five kingdom system is a hit machine, or that type of five kingdom system we follow nowadays, five kingdom classification system only for the division of the whole living system. Okay, so for the study of the five kingdom classification system, what he did, he decides some criteria. That criteria are, he decides five types of criteria. On the basis of that five types of criteria, he divides whole living system. In that, a very first criteria is complexity of cell structure. Complexity of cell structure, that means he divides into two, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes. The meaning of prokaryotes is, pro means primitive, karyotes, karyon means nucleus, that means primitive nucleus. As the name, eukaryotes, eu means true, and karyon means nucleus, that means true nucleus. Prokaryotes means primitive nucleus or before nucleus. Eukaryotes means true nucleus. So, according to the complexity of the cell structure, he derived a two classification, that is prokaryotes and eukaryotes. After that, he decided a second criteria for the classification system. What he did? He did a complexity of the organism. In that system, he divides a two column. First one is the unicellular, second one is the multicellular. As you have already studied about the unicellular and multicellular in previous classes, unicellular, that means with it arise from a single cell. Uni means single. Always uni, that means single, and multi means more than one. As we can say, multiplex. Kya karte hain hum? Multiplex. वो डबल स्टोरीज बिल्डिंग बहुत सारे जिसमें स्टोरीज रहेंगी वो बिल्डिंग. सो एज वी कैन नो, यूनिसेल्यूलर सिंगल सेल्ड ऑर्गेनिज्म, मल्टीसेल्यूलर मोर देन वन सेल इज प्रेजेंट इन दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो आफ्टर दैट द थर्ड पॉइंट फॉर द क्लासिफिकेशन पर्पस ऑफ आर एच विटाकर, व्हाट इट डिड, मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज द थर्ड क्राइटेरिया. In that mode of nutrition, what he did? Plants. He divides a plant into the autotrophic one. Autotrophic. What does it mean? Autotrophic. That means they prepare their own food by their own. खुद का खाना भाई खुद बनाते हैं वो. ठीक है? दूसरों से खाना लेंगे नहीं. Plants कैसे करते हैं? खुद का खाना खुद prepare करेंगे. ठीक है? After that, we'll see fungi, saprophytic one. In that saprophyte, they absorb a food from dead and decaying matter. जो dead and decaying matter रहेंगे, उससे ये food absorb करेंगे. After that, the third is animals. They are heterotrophic one. We all are a heterotrophic. We all are heterotrophic. Why? Because हम खुद का खाना खुद नहीं बनाते. ठीक है? We gain our food from the plants. हम प्लांट से लेते, then हम हमारा जो फूड है वो कंज्यूम करते. So in that way, plants are autotrophic one. Second one is the fungi, that is a saprophytic one, and third one is the animals. These all are a heterotrophic one. So he divides a fourth third criteria, that is mode of nutrition, and with that mode of nutrition he divides plant, autotrophic one, fungi, saprophytic one, and animals, that is heterotrophic. Okay, from that fourth point, fourth criteria, on the basis of that Whittaker divides whole system into some limitations and into the criteria. The fourth system for the classification is lifestyle, that is producers. So who are the plants? Kaun hai bhai? So plants, they are producers. So consumers, animals, we are consumers only. We are not producers. So plants are producers and animals are the consumers. So and decomposers are fungi. Fungi are decomposers. So clear with that point? Plant, producers, animals, consumers and fungi, decomposer. Then fifth point came into the picture. The criteria for the classification is phylogenetic relationship. So in that case of phylogenetic relationship, the prokaryote to the eukaryote and unicellular to the multicellular. This is the criteria for the phylogenetic relationship. अब हम फाइलोजेनेटिक रिलेशनशिप की अगर हम बात करें, मैं आपको समझाना चाहूंगा कि यहां पे उसने प्रोकैरियोट्स प्रिमिटिव न्यूक्लियस टू द यूकैरियोट्स, दैट मींस ट्रू न्यूक्लियस, प्रिमिटिव न्यूक्लियस टू द ट्रू न्यूक्लियस एंड यूनिसेल्यूलर टू द मल्टीसेल्यूलर, दैट मींस सिंगल सेल ऑर्गेनिज्म टू द मल्टीपल सेल ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो ही डिवाइड्स होल लिविंग सिस्टम इनटू द five kingdom classification system, and these five kingdom classification systems are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia, and here these all are the criteria for the five kingdom classification system. What are they? The first criteria is the complexity of the cell. Second one is the complexity of the organism. In that he included unicellular to multicellular. Third one is the mode of nutrition. What type of nutrition are they having? Then fourth one is the lifestyles. They are producers, consumers, decomposers. Then fifth point is the phylogenetic relationship, that means prokaryote to eukaryote, unicellular to multicellular. So here is the five kingdom classification system by R.H. Whittaker. So in that five kingdom classification system, firstly divides into the two categories, that means prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. As we have already said, prokaryotes, that means pro, primitive, karyons, nucleus, eu, that means true, karyons means nucleus, primitive nucleus, and second one is the true nucleus. So here first division is the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In that it lacks a slim membrane bound nucleus and it is having a nucleus within a membrane. Then below that, the second division is the unicellular and the multicellular. As we have already said about phylogenetic relationship, prokaryote to eukaryote and then unicellular to multicellular. So in that, a second division is unicellular, and the unicellular, a very first division is kingdom 1 Monera. Kingdom 1 Monera, that means in that living organism, prokaryotic unicellular kingdom 1 Monera. In that they are having all the type of autotrophs. Okay, mode of nutrition, autotrophic, they all are autotrophic. In okay, after that, second kingdom eukaryotic unicellular, that is kingdom 2 Protista, they all are included in a autotrophic to the heterotrophic. They are not belong to specifically autotrophic or heterotrophic. They move to the autotrophic to the heterotrophic. Okay, and the example is amoeba, a very specific and special example for the kingdom 2 Protista, and the example is amoeba. So after that, kingdom 3, first division is the eukaryotes, eukaryotic multicellular. As we have already said about multicellular, that means more than one cell. Okay, so eukaryotes multicellular. In that kingdom 3 fungi. Okay, cell wall present in that fungi, cell wall is present. but can't perform photosynthesis. Okay, and they are heterotrophic one. Okay, we can specifically called it as a saprophytic. That means they are dependent on the food with the dead and decaying matter. Okay, after that, these in the fungi, the cell wall is made up of a tough and complex sugar called it as a chitin. Okay, and the examples are Baker's yeast and the penicillium. Third kingdom is the fungi. Then we'll move ahead with the fourth kingdom, and that is eukaryotic and multicellular kingdom for planty, and cell wall is present in a plants. All the plants in that kingdom, cell wall is present and they can perform a photosynthesis. Arey bhai, unhi se to lete hain hum khana. Okay, so they perform a photosynthesis. They are autotrophic in a nature. A mode of nutrition is autotrophic. So here is the kingdom 4, that is planty. So after that, multicellular, eukaryotic, multicellular, kingdom 5, that is animalia. And in that animalia, there is no cell wall present in that, and they all are heterotrophic. Arey bhai, aap aur main, we all are comes under that fifth kingdom group, that is animalia. Okay, so these all are the five kingdom system: monera, protista, fungi, planty, animalia. Say abhi aapko ek example to learn the five kingdom classification system with a trick. Main ek trick batane ja raha hu. Very first, aap farz karo ki monera, aapke class mein ek mona naam ki koi student hai, और वो आपके क्लास में आते हैं और वो आपको क्या देके जाते हैं, प्रोटीन्स देके जाते हैं. आप बाकी के क्लास में पूरे बच्चे बहुत ज्यादा वीक है, वो प्रोटीन देके जाते हैं, बट उस प्रोटीन को फंगस लग जाता है और वो फंगस लग जाने के बाद में आप वो प्रोटीन है वो झाड़ों को दे देते हैं. वो झाड़ को देने के बाद में वो आ गया प्लांटी. झाड़ यानी क्या हो गया भाई, प्लांट्स हो गए, प्लांटी. एंड देन उसके बाद में वो प्लांट्स के पास में पड़ा रहता है, प्लांट्स भी उसको कुछ नहीं खा पाते, इसीलिए फाइनली एनिमल्स, इसीलिए किंगडम एनिमलिया. ये एक लाइन में आपको ध्यान में आ जाएगा कि मोना नाम की कोई स्टूडेंट, उन्होंने आपको प्रोटीन गिफ्ट किया प्रोटिस्टा, उसके बाद में उस प्रोटीन को लग गया फंगस फंजाई, एंड देन उसे उन्होंने डाल दिया प्लांट्स के पास में प्लांटी, और वो बाद में एनिमल्स ही खा गए एनिमलिया. सो हियर इज द फाइव किंगडम सिस्टम क्लासिफिकेशन. एज ऑफ नाउ वी ऑल आर फॉलोड दीज दैट स्पेसिफिक फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम by the R.H. Whittaker. But a very well known question and a very famous question arise into your mind, maybe aapke dimag mein wo aa sakta hai ki viruses kahan gaye, theek hai, viruses ko kahan include karenge. So the answer is viruses are not included in the five kingdom classification system. Kyunki they are not made by living things. Okay, this is the reason why viruses are not included in that five kingdom classification system. So here is the five kingdom classification system: monera, protista, fungi, planty, animalia. Thank you.